Hello friends, in the previous video we have seen what is the necessity of active learning. Now we discuss active learning what. In active learning method, students actively participate in learning process. They are not passive listeners. Laboratory session is a common example of active learning where do they work in group or in pair. Even a small group discussing about a topic, they are developing the model, they are solving some problem together, we may call it as an active learning. Neuroscience research has proved that the learning happens when brain creates new neural connections. Active learning promotes creation of new neural connections and retention of long-term memory. So what is active learning? It is student-centric. We switch our center from teacher-centric to student-centric. Again, here we have two types. Individual learning, where student individually engaged in learning process. They may give seminar or PowerPoint presentation, oral. Or they may work in group. We call it as a collaborative learning. It enhances their ability to work in team. So what are the advantages of group activity? You may pause the button, pause the video and write your responses. I hope you have written your response. In the group, it helps to enhance interpersonal relationship, improve communication, and develops leadership quality. These are advantages of group activity. Now, one more drawback we have in collaborative learning, that interpersonal conflicts may arise in the discussion. And in the group, some students are superior, they are more enthusiastic and aggressive, and some weaker students, they have some inferiority complex, less confident, and they do not participate, but grading is assigned to the group. So this is the drawback of collaborative learning. So now we come to cooperative learning. This is the improvised version of collaborative learning. Cooperative, the word itself is self-explanatory. It means you assist each other. The basic principle of cooperative learning is, in group, every group member has to ensure that every other member has learned the concept, understood the concept. What are the elements of cooperative learning? It is a group activity. So first important element is positive interdependence. Every group member is given a specific task and he or she is responsible for that, and his contribution is very important to the success of the group. So everybody has to actively participate. Nobody can remain idle. Group heterogeneity. We must have a mixed group of diverse background, variety of abilities, attitude, interest. The most important here is the promoting interaction. So it is very important when we say a group work, it doesn't mean that every group member is assigned a small bit. But it will not that every member will complete his assignment individually, separately, and they just put it together and staple together. It is not expected in cooperative learning. Here we expect that all the members come together, discuss, debate, argue, and then they come to a common consensus. Individual accountability means everybody has to participate, has to complete his own share. Everybody is responsible for success of the group. Use of interpersonal skill, time management, communication, leadership. They must be able to conflict the dissolution if arises in the group. So what is the role of teacher in cooperative learning? It doesn't mean that the students, they are self-learners and the teacher will just assign the work, give some activity and remain idle. Rather, I would say that here the role of teacher is very significant and very difficult. So what he has to do? First of all, he has to educate the students about cooperative learning. What is cooperative learning and why do we incorporate it in our teaching learning process? Then he has to define unit learning objective, unit outcome. He has to decide the group size, whether they have to work in pair or in a group of 4 to 5, 6 to 8 or any other else. Fix sitting arrangement, because we expect face-to-face interaction, not the individual work, putting it together. Then he has to distribute the bits of the topic, means he has to divide the given topic in small bits and he has to distribute it. He has to make available the resource material. He cannot say that this is the topic given to you and complete the activity. He must study material, he must make it available to the students. Teach social skill, means nobody should behave aggressively. Everybody has to listen carefully to others' views, others' opinion. And teacher must evaluate the performance of the group and group members. So what are the techniques that we can use in cooperative learning? Think, pair, share, peer instruction, jigsaw, three-step interview, round-robin brainstorming, 3-minute review, and so many others are there. But in the next videos, we are going to talk about think, pair, share and peer instruction. Thank you.